still very much in the confusion of what this lesson is and all these lessons are as they're unfolding and happening, because there's stuff here and I can tell it's around confidentiality, it's around leadership, it's around broadcast versus distributed, and it's around my own anti-authority hierarchy stuff and how much of that is real in what we need in the world and how much is my own shadow and shit and I need to get rid of it. And so the things I've been dealing with over the last few weeks, the community piece, which honestly is barely a blip on the radar. Last time it was the biggest event that year. And this time it's like, yeah. And it was a bigger event really this time. This time I was more shocked, not by the person who did it, because she had done it before, but by like someone coming and not leaving your doorway and insisting on having the conversation, you can't close the door. Like, that's just so ridiculous still even a couple weeks later. But I don't feel like emotion around this needs to go this way. I'm just like, guess we can't interact. We'll have to figure that out. We'll have to figure out how to stay apart in a tiny, tiny community. Not physically apart, but, you know, like not talk to one another, not trigger one another. And then the Kyle Cease thing, which is both big, but it's also happened before in my life. I had a spiritual teacher who, although I'd never met him, just like I've never really met Kyle Cease, had a fall from grace around women and grossness of spiritual and like crossing the line that wasn't illegal, but what, like, just ew. And this is also just like ew. And it's, I'm more ew around the lack of integrity and authenticity and like my story around who Kyle Cease was. And this beautiful part that is like, oh, you're not more evolved than me. You truly are evolving out loud and I'm evolving faster. And that's my own shit, my own story. I don't think anyone evolves faster. I don't think anyone's more worthy than anyone else. But like that, I had him on a pedestal without even quite realizing. And then when he knocked down, it was like, oh no, we are actually, I'm more authentic. I am dealing with my stuff out loud. I am like, this is who I am. And as I learn, I like, because I also have the freedom to do that. I don't have my money tied up in this, right? I could go viral for the wrong reason and everyone could hate me, but I still have my family and friends. I am safe enough that I can do that. And that's part of the cost of leadership and of having a movement and followers of any kind, whether they're customers, members, clients, that there's a cost to them by you falling from grace if you're the leader and they're all following you. But when it's distributed, that doesn't happen in the same way. And now I've been made an admin, a moderator, not actually quite clear of the title, for the Game B Facebook group. And there's both like internal feelings in me of like, oh, that's too much. And I don't know. And the part of it's true that the like executive functioning of deciding what's confidential and what's not, and where am I wearing an admin hat, and where am I wearing Jubilee hat, and where am I wearing the Together Tech hat, and where am I wearing no hats? Where am I just like, what is that? And that's part of it. And then like confidentiality of being an admin and my mission on this planet, and especially the guidance I'm getting right now, is to like share my journey authentically. And where there are barriers to that, where there are places I can't share, that's a problem for me. And so that might be the reason I have to leave the admin team. But right now it feels like a good tension. It feels like this is my learning to come up against. Like, it's like, okay, you have to figure out how to follow someone else's guidance, right? Like, this group has its own guidance that is, you know, has more, some people that are more in leadership roles than others, and what I feel about that, which I'm like, you know, is this person's Facebook group or is it Game B, even if they're one of the people who came up with Game B? And that brings up other stuff with brain tumor groups that I could go into a whole other time. Yeah, and just the like need for confidentiality for this group, and this group has decided it, so if I'm there, I have to follow that. But at the same time, being able to share my journey authentically and share things that come up for me. And so that is a line I have to follow. That is like, I'm gonna have to figure that out, and I might cross it sometimes and figure that out. And either when I cross it, if I do, does that mean I have to leave? I don't think it'll mean I'm not gonna do anything atrocious. Doesn't mean I'll be kicked out of Game B completely. And even if I am, Game B still exists all around. And so that is just what I'm sitting with, the same for like leadership and sovereignty and confidentiality and following the stories, the path.